Hey there everyone, welcome to yet another Flutter Mentor video. I'm going to go ahead and leave the link to the documentation for both the text field and the text form field so you can check for further reference. And as always, do not forget there are subtitles available, so turn them on if you need to. Now this will be a two-part video because otherwise it would be way too long. This is part one where I will go through how to visually manipulate your text field. And then in part two, which will be released in about 3 weeks or four, I will go over some of the most popular properties of this widget when it comes to functionality. But if I show you here the list, as you can see, there's way too many to go over all of them. So it will be only the main ones. But let's go ahead and get started. I'm only going to be decorating the text field because anything I do to the text field will be applicable to the text form field. Decoration wise, they are pretty much the same widget. Now, you may be wondering what the difference is between the two text fields, and it's mostly quite obvious because of the name, text form field. Okay, text form field is supposed to belong to a form where there's validation going on and stuff, and text field is just a much more simple kind of text field for basic information input. And to style it, you only need to know one property, which is the decoration. However, beyond this, you actually do need to know quite a lot, which is why I'm linking the documentation on this video's description, because there's a lot to learn. But I will show you how to make a good enough looking text field. So inside this property, you can apply the input decoration widget. Now within this widget, let's say you want to give the text field a color, then you must set the filled property to true. And if we save, you will notice that it is filled. It happens to be a very similar color to the background, but you can see it, right? If you can't, let's just go ahead and change the fill color. Let's make it white. Why not? Seeing as the background is gray. And just in case you want to know how to use an icon, we can also go for it here. Simply use the icon property and then the icon class. And now let's pick a random icon here. Why not use this guy here? He seems happy. Now, if you want to change the color of the icon, you just gotta do this because the icon class has its own color property. Let's make it, I don't know, red might look ugly, but why not? Let's make it red accent. It looks terrible. So terrible, I'm just gonna change it to maybe green accent. Now, since this is a text field, you probably need a placeholder, which is referred to here as a hint text, which takes a string. Let's say personal email here, why not? And there you have it. However, say you wanted to change the color of the hint text. It's as simple as hint style and then text style. And you can pretty much do anything you would to a regular text widget here. In this case, let's just change the color to, I don't know, I don't want to make it too ugly. This is just to show you. I guess I'll just do this and, you know what? I'll just leave it. Now let's take care of the borders because it's looking kind of weird, you know? It has this little blue line underneath and then it doesn't have it anywhere else. Even if I click away, you can still see it. So it definitely doesn't look good. So let's change that. Now remember, we're still in the input decoration widget, okay? This is still a property of that widget and it's the border property. Now, you may be a little bit confused if you come here and you check, and by the way, this is on Windows, and here it tells you what it expects. It expects an input border type. And you may be thinking, oh, I don't know. But actually, they do give you some suggestions here, which is actually very helpful. In fact, I'm going to use this one right here, input border.none. Now, if you do Control Q again, you will see that it belongs to an abstract class called input border. And if I save now, you will see there is no more a blue line underneath. And now it's starting to look quite good, to be honest. But let's say you do want a border all around. This can't be a thing then, because you need borders. So instead, you need to do border, and then here you need to use a widget that is also type outline input border. And in here is where the magic will happen. So first, let's give this a border radius. Let's not make it too big, and let's give it to all the corners. As you can see, this expects a radius. So all you gotta do is type in radius.circular, and then give this a double value. 10 should work very well most of the times. And let's see how it looks now. There it is. And as you can see, now there's a border all around and the corners are edged. But let's say you don't want the border at all, you just want the edged corners. All you gotta do is come here, border side, and then do border side dot none. If you save this, it's gone. And this is honestly a pretty good looking text field already. Let's see what color the text we input looks like. Hello. Okay, that's black. Imagine you want to change this. All you gotta do is come over here to the initial text field widget and use the property style and then text style. And then simply just change the color. Let's make it ugly again. Colors are red. And there you go. It's now red. And this is a good start for decorating your text field. You can do a whole lot more. The possibilities are nearly endless. I really advise you to just play around with it. Do what I did. Give it ugly colors, make it as ugly as possible. Just really test out the limits of Flutter on here. And that's how you learn how to change the decoration of your text style. Always use control space in each widget to see all the possible properties you can use and experiment with them. Before we go, I will just go over the most basic way to access the value of your text field, which is the unchanged property. The unchanged property takes a function that provides you with a value. In this anonymous function, you can give the value that you get from the text field to another variable. For example, let's say you come here and you create a string called whatever. Then you come over here and all you gotta do is say, whatever equals value. And let's print this so you know what's going on. Whatever. Now, if you go back to the app, let me just open this up so you can see it. And you type in anything at all. Anytime it changes, it updates the value of the variable, which is pretty great. There's other ways to do it using a controller, but I will go over that in the next part of this topic. So without anything else to add, this is Flutter Mentor and out.